Hello guys, welcome back to another Blade and Sword Revolution guide video. In this video guys, I'm gonna show you best way to increase your power fast, so your CP, however you want, combat power, power, okay? As you can see right here, I'm level 92, almost 93, and here you can see my stats, my attack 17,585 and defense 17,571. You can see my gear. And wait till the end of the video, I'm gonna show you how you can get, for example, this type of gear, Radiant gear. It's actually also set, you can get the weapon and some accessories. Okay, so this one, it's stronger than the other blue gear. Okay, it's Radiant, I'm gonna show you, and I'm gonna show you all the ways to increase your power, including gear enhancing and other ways. So let's get started. Okay, so if we go to character, here you can see my info and wardrobe. So wardrobe are actually costumes, okay, and these ones, if you check, each will give you specific stats. Like this one gives me PvP, a tank and defense, this defense and accuracy, and so on. So, and there are higher grades that will give you even more stats. See, okay, this one's, okay, I'm legendary, check this one, nice. So if you check in here, also there is headgear, same thing, they have extra stats. This, all these stats, okay, once you have a specific costume or headgear outfit, you see here active bonuses. This is the total, so all those bonuses will stack up, which is amazing. So a good way to increase your power is getting all these outfits and headgear, so that way all your stats will go up. How you can get these ones? Well, one way is crafting, and I'm gonna go right now. Actually, I think that's the I'm not sure if it's the only way, but pretty sure. Okay, let's see. Crafting, you have to go in a town and to a merchant, general merchant, and in here guys you have a list for outfits that you can craft. See, up to legendary you can craft, and the materials, a list of the materials. This, for example, it will show for the ones that you have the design. Okay, see, I have for this one the design and this one, this is the design. So the hardest piece maybe to get is the design. Where you can get the designs? Some you can buy from the shop, merchants, some you'll get from dungeons, events, and so on. The rest of the materials also you can get them from hunting, from some quests, maybe field hunting, see, normal dungeons, prize boards, and shop. Also you can buy, for example, I'm gonna show here materials, click materials, and here you can see all the materials that you can buy. Okay, these ones you need for crafting. So if you don't have enough materials to craft some costume or gear, because gear also can be crafted, then you can go to the merchant and see if it has those materials. Also, if you disassemble gear, you can get materials. Okay, now let's see what else. So costume or wardrobe, it's a good way to increase your power. Another way, skills, you have lots of skills. Skills, passive and utility skills. Skills, let's go to skills. Okay, these are the skills that I have, and they are all level one. How you, I'm gonna try to increase this. Ultimate stance, you have different stances also. These are the base skills. All of them, they can be leveled up using the silver or the coins and these blue skill points, let's call them like that. I'm gonna show you in here. Let me see if I still have some of those. I think I already used. But they look like this. These are essences. Okay, essences, that's how they are called. These ones will give you these skills. These are for passive skills. Let's go and open. This you can get from hunting, you can get also from shop. So there are many ways, from quests and so on. from dungeons. Okay, let me go to skills and try to level up. Let's see how much power. First, this is level 3. Here you can see the increase in the power. Let's level up the... Okay, amazing. So this is one way. I'm gonna do more after. But definitely I recommend the ultimate. This stance is very powerful, so I'll level up this one. Okay. The wind wield is very powerful also, skill for me. Ultimate stances can be also leveled up. Okay, let me... And... Okay, I'm gonna do that after the video. But let's see. My power should have went up. Yeah, 17,600. Okay. Now, we have also utility skills and passive. Okay, passive skills, you need the green ones, the green essences, essence of passivity. And see, for level 20, level specific level, you have to reach to unlock those passive skills that can be leveled up same way. So I recommend to invest in the attack power as much as you can. This will increase your power, especially for attack, is very important, and defense. So I'm gonna try to get and some, let's put some into block. Okay, I need more skills. But see, I leveled up my attack power. Let's check my stats. Oops. Sorry. Okay, 17,806. Okay, so it went up. Okay, now let's see. So passive skills also will increase your power. Now let's go to items another way. There are pets, guys. So pets is another way. How? Because if you summon them, okay, and if their health is full, okay, like this, you can use this pet pods. Okay, you can buy them from here. I don't have right now. Okay, make sure their health is above 60%, okay, 100%, because they will give you special options for buff, silver gain, and base stats increase, like stamina, HP, critical damage. Also, these pets can be fused, can be ascended. Ascended is how you improve their stats. Just register, and you need these guardian stones to level them up, okay? I'm gonna do maybe a separate video about them. So just know, if you summon pets, and the higher the grade for the pets, the better stats they have. Also, these pets can be leveled up or ascended, so pets can improve your power. Now let's see, we have codex, another great way, guys. What is codex? Here is acquiring all different grades of weapon, accessories, sword shields, pets, and so on. If you have a complete set like in here, I will get this stat: defense, block, critical defense, okay? And the higher tier, if I go to superior, they will give you even higher stats, like legendary will give you the highest. So what you have to do, just check what you need for each collection, okay? Receive again, let's get the stats, boom, see? Soul shields, for weapons also. So check what you're missing from this collection, and then let's see, I'm gonna show you, for example, I have here missing this one, okay? So that means I would necklace. I can go in here to the merchant, the equipment merchant, go to crafting and go to necklace. And you see right here, I have the design owned. So I can craft this one and complete that set. That will give me more stats, which is amazing, no? So completing those collection for gear, for all those things, it's another good way to increase your power. Okay, codex. What else we have? I'm gonna talk about soon about the gear, so just wait a little bit. We have challenges, okay, in here. So another great way, guys, is contribution. Contribution, what is this? So each region and each area, so Vidian cost, okay? If click here, you see all those areas for the Viridian coast, sorry. Bamboo Village. You see, if you I defeat monsters, collect stuff, okay? I will gain this rank, okay? Current rank completion, okay? So I have grade 2. You can check in here what stats you can get. Attack power, maximum weight. Max rank for this one is 3. For, let's see, in here I already have one. So let's see how that works. See, I already completed and rank complete, and I get these stats, okay, which is amazing. For next rank, what I will see, they will increase block critical damage. So you can check each area what stats you want. You want maybe more attack, more HP, more defense, and see what you have to do in that area, what monster, and or you can press move, it will go there, and with the rank up, okay, all the way to rank 5, some of them, and increase all your stats. All these stats will stack up. Overall progress. Let's see, it doesn't. Let me see if it shows. See, here you can see total reputation stats, attack power, piercing, everything. They are all combined in here. So this is a good way to increase your power. Okay, now I think we should talk about the gear, the equipment. Okay, so equipment definitely is a good way to increase your power. Here you can see I have weapon accessories, and on the second tab you have the soul shields. Soul shields, they are up to 8, and they have also different grades, same like the gear. The higher the grade, the more stats. Like for example, the blue ones give you higher stats. And for same thing for the gear, the higher the grade, the better stats will give. The best one I showed you with crafting are the legendary ones. Let's go to weapon. So you have white, then you have green, then you have blue, okay, like this one. You have this purple one, which is heroic, and the highest right now I think is this legendary, which is orange. Here you can see the stats, crazy stats. All of this can be crafted, and the materials I told you can get them from, for example, for this one. Let's see, if we scroll down, how to obtain this, you can obtain from heroic dungeon. Okay, let's see the purple one. Let's scroll down. How to obtain the receipt? This is the design, okay? Because that's the hardest. This is from Heaven Mandate normal, okay? But you can craft like this one. See, I can craft right now available. I already have the design. This I got from, let me see, how to obtain field hunting. Normal dungeon, heroic dungeon, and raids. So they can be obtained also from hunting, which is a good thing. But the higher the grade, the lower the drop rate. Okay, so you can craft the gear. Also, you can get the gear from adventure, from dungeon, daily dungeons. Field bosses can give you also. Don't forget about field bosses. So here you can see risk of rewards. This one is quite strong. I'm gonna try to get it. If you go to Tomb of Exile, you have even better, like this one, but you need higher level, level 90. Now I should be able to go for this one. You can buy more entries from here for specific dungeon. Tomb of Exile, see, up to 4 per week with the silver or coins at 4. With the these gems, okay? Now, so buying more entries can give you more gear. So you can craft also, you can get receipts for the like or purple accessory, which is amazing. The higher the dungeon, the better the gear. Okay, here you can see, let's see what we can get. Okay, nice. And you can get these receipts for heroic, see, weapon and some accessory, which is amazing. So dungeons, rides also, don't forget, rides can give you even more, but you unlock at level 190. Here you can see the receipts you can get and so on. Events also, events, this event actually is very important. This Hong Moon dungeon can give you, guys, this gear. And check this out, this is Radiant gear, which is stronger than the normal blue gear. So this is one way to get this Radiant gear. I have one, like this one is, I think this is one is the best. So don't forget to do the event dungeon. How you can get more entries? Well, you can buy from here. Also, you can get from the event, that is, if you press event here, you see, you get entry from here. And also, you get event tokens. See, like I got in here. If you complete all, you get this also, full set of accessories and weapon. Let's see. And if you go to shop, and in here, if you go to events, you see with the event coins what you can buy, guys. So you can buy enhancement stones, you can buy soul shields and enhancement for short soul shields. I'm gonna show you how you can enhance that. Essences for skills, okay. Radiant accessory enhancement, which is amazing, and really good thing that you should get. I don't know if you get 3000, you can get this poor heroic accessories, guys. Just 3000 event coins, or you can get this, I got one, Radiant Superior Event Equipment Chest, that will give you one of this Radiant equipment, okay? I got one, that's how I got the, I'm gonna show you, this is the one that I got, Radiant Bracelet. So they have higher stats than normal blue gear. Okay, now let's see how you can enhance this gear. One way is an enhance, okay? So you select and you need this enhancement materials. After level 5, if you fail, you'll decrease the durability. If the durability will see those dots, I still have one durability. So let's try, see if I can get higher. So this will increase your base stats, guys, okay? Enhancing. If you succeed. Okay, so I just failed, so I lost the durability. If I do it again, I try again, it will damage the equipment, so the equipment won't be able, you won't be able to sell it. You'll have to repair it to sell it or to enhance it further. Okay, so that's how it works. After plus 10, okay, let's, like this weapon, you get extra special option. See right here, recover party 0.6 life per second for 10 seconds upon successfully block, and 20 seconds cooldown. So you get a special option if you reach plus 10. So try to get your gear to plus 10, guys, okay? Make sure you have the materials. I think this ones, guys, okay? These ones you can get, they are, you can craft them. You can get from quest, you can get also, I think, from dungeons and so on. So there are many ways to get these materials, weapon and armor and accessory enhancement. So there are three types for each type of gear, weapon, armor and accessories. Another way, guys, to improve your gear is reforging, okay? So what reforging will do, will randomize these stats, okay? See, the attack power, piercing, threat and critical damage. If you click here, you see the best that you get is either SSS or L. Okay, here you can see the maximum stats you can get, like attack power 54, piercing 327. So try to get the highest stats. If you got one good stat like this one and this one, and let's say this one, so all those, sorry, let's fix this and piercing. So the other one, you need fixed stones. See right there, I'm using 5 and forged stones. Okay, so let me try, see if I get a higher rate for the last one. The ones that you wanted to be fixed, okay, they will stay the same, but you need fixed forged stones. Okay, if you do random all, you need only forged stones, okay? But you don't want to risk, if you get an SS or L, to lose it. So that's why you need those fix and use the fixed stones. So that's how you can get extra power. Usually when you get an equipment, you'll have like grade C, the lowest grades. So do the reforging. Another way is to level up the soul shields. You can use also soul shields, or you can use this materials for leveling up soul shields. See, this one will give me level. Let's select a different one. Let's level up this level 18. This will give me level 30. Boom. There we go. Okay. Let's see what else. There is also repairing. I already talked. So you can repair the gear. So you need the same grade to repair it. The same gear. Blue with blue. Okay, so that's how it works. Restoration success chance 1/400%. I don't want to do it right now. Maybe I'll do it for other equipment. So these are, guys, some of the best ways. Maybe I forgot to tell you about some of different ones, but these are right now the best ways to increase your power. Let me know what you think. Let me tell me your power, and see you guys in the next video. Bye.